Okay, now this is the expression for Young modulus, modulus of rigidity and mu, and we will find out one relation. Okay, so already we know that shear strain, that phi is equal to shear stress, that means we have got modulus of rigidity is equal to shear stress by shear strain. Okay, and also you have got the relation between ES, shear stress by shear strain. Now we will find out the relation between Young modulus, modulus of rigidity and mu. Okay, so for that make a object of diagonal SC. Okay, so here you can see the diagonal BD and diagonal SC. Now if you apply that shear stress along this direction, what will happen? As the bottom is fixed, so that portion will be deformed. Okay, so the diagonal A will extend, SC will elongate. Okay, and the diagonal BC will compressed. So suppose this is E, so that is 90 degree perpendicular, so that becomes CC dash. Now longitudinal strain along the diagonal AC along the diagonal SC, that is equal to changing length by original length, so that will be SC dash minus SC divided by SC, changing length by original length. Now SC dash minus SC is equal to EC dash by AC. Now we have to find out the EC. Now we have considered that is 45 degree. Okay, so CA, this angle is 45 degree, or you can say that angle is ACB, that angle is also 45 degree. Now as the deformation is very small, we consider that there is no change in angle, so that remains in 45 degree. So what is EC? That EC is equal to CC dash into cos 45 degree. So that is equal to CC dash divided by root 2. So it ultimately CC dash by root 2 into SC. Now again, SC square is equal to, we know that AB square plus BC square. So SC is equal to, if you consider AB is equal to BC, so that ultimately BC square plus BC square root. So it will be 2 root BC. So S is equal to BC square plus BC square, so it will be root 2 into BC. So BC, S is equal to, we can write root 2 into BC, so ultimately we can write that CC dash by root 2 into BC, that means CC dash by BC 1 by root 2. Now CC dash by BC, CC dash by BC, that is equal to shear strain, that already we have taken. So we can write CC dash by BC is equal to phi by root 2. Okay. Again, we know that phi is equal to shear stress by modulus of rigidity. Because modulus of rigidity is shear stress by shear strain, so shear strain is equal to modulus shear stress divided by modulus of rigidity. So we can write here shear stress divided by phi is equal to, we can write root 2 will be replaced by root 2 is there, so it will be only 2. Okay, so it will be 2c. Okay, again from the geometry of this figure, again we know that longitudinal strain on the diagonal AC, that is equal to longitudinal strain on diagonal AC due to the strain on the diagonal AC due to the tensile stress on AC, that is due to tensile strain on diagonal AC due to tensile stress. Tensile strain is on the diagonal AC due to the tensile stress minus, that is tensile strain. Another will be, it will be linear strain. So another will be lateral strain on BD due to one on the diagonal AC it will elongate and diagonal BD will compress. So here will be lateral strain and here will be linear strain. So ultimately we can write this is linear strain minus B into this, only linear strain as a lateral strain. So tau by E minus plus mu into tau by E. So tau by E common 1 plus mu. So longitudinal strain along the diagonal, earlier we have got phi is equal to this tau by twice C. Okay, so that tau will cancel, so E will be 2C into 1 plus mu. So one relation you have got, E is equal to 2C 1 plus mu. Another we have got, E is equal to 3K 1 minus 2 mu. So in place of 3K, earlier I have not given 3. So we have to replace this as a 3K, because we have considered sigma x, sigma y and sigma z is equal to sigma. So there will be 3 sigma. So 3 sigma, 3 will be there. So I have not given 3. So you put 3. Now we will find out the relation between E, C and K. Young modulus, bulk modulus and modulus of rigidity. So you know E is equal to 2C 1 plus mu is equal to 3K 1 minus 2 mu. Okay. So from this equation, if you remove this mu, so we have to do one thing. E by 2C is equal to 1 plus mu from this equation. So mu is equal to E by 2C minus 1. Now again E is equal to 3K 1 minus 2 mu. So put this mu here. So it will be 3k 1 minus 2 e by 2c minus 1. Okay. So this 3k 1 minus 3e divided by 2e divided by 2c minus minus plus, that will be 2. So that will be 3k, that is 3 minus e by c. So we can write here 3k 3c minus e divided by c. So we can write 9kc minus, that will be 3kc, that is equal to ec. Okay, so ec is equal to, we can write 9kc, 9kc and ke, 9kc minus 3ke, 3ke this. So ec minus 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 plus 3ke is equal to 9kc. So E will be there, another E will be there. So you can take simply E common, C plus 3k will be 9kc. So we can write E is equal to 9kc divided by C plus 3k. So that relation we can make. So relation between Young modulus, modulus of rigidity and bulk modulus. Okay. So you have seen how to find out the relation between the different elastic constraints. So hope you have understood. Thank you.